You know, when this invitation came from Retail Association of India to me about 3 weeks back, would you consider giving a talk? I was a bit hesitant because I'm not a retailer, never worked in retail, never ever sold to a retail association as to what could be done, etc. Then I was also asking the organizers, what will a software services company do in a retail-specific association? But having accepted it, in the last 3 weeks, I spent a lot of time with these startups, and the startups put across, I'm giving a perspective the way we see things are going across. And we heard of, just before I proceed, how many of you are retailers here in this room? Service providers? My dear startups? That shows. So we'll have two of you, my panel members also is good. So let's take you forward the way we see retail in 2025. And thereafter, I have a panel discussion where the good service providers, technology providers, and the panel discussant will discuss many of the issues is going to impact put across. The three things we are talking about 2025, the retail is going to be impacted. A, how does it deal with consumers? What is the way to look at technology? And third is, what is the impact on societal changes? Let's analyze one by one. This one. You must be all be familiar with this. If you notice, as also Rakesh Biyani talked about, at any point of time today, every person in the planet has got a phone, smartphone, or a phone which is there, approximately 6.8 billion. Approximately 2.1 billion people are online. Approximately 1 billion people are today on Facebook and social media chat taking place. All of them are completely shifting the way the business is going to be done. It's a reality. In India too, the numbers are no different. India too, unfortunately, we have three different kinds of population. First, 300 million population which has got smartphones. The next 200 million population has got a phone. The last 400 million people are yet to come to the smartphone area. The way you're looking at this, all of them are completely going to change the way an in-store and an online store experience is completely going to change. I'll tell you how. The technology is going to change, is going to impact in all the four elements: engagement, discovery, experience, and interactions. In all these elements of the retail is taking place, technology is going to play a big role. For example, is your real-time anomaly detection, if it is taking place in a big application area, what we're discovering, people are making use of it. It could be areas of, say, demand forecasting, the sale forecasting which is taking place. It could be a natural language processing that is taking place, machine language taking place. How do I get machine to accept, artificial intelligence to accept, how the people are behaving in customer experience, all of them leading to extreme personalization. Extreme personalization. Our own experience, having interacted with several online channels and also physical format stores, is that people in the online channel are able to have an external personalization, where they are finding it unable to repeat in the in-store. How are they able to convert the customer service agent into a customer loyalist program agent? Those are the kind of stuff what we're looking at it. In each of these places, we expect a complete technology interference taking place, whether the way you discover a product, the way you engage with the customer, etc. All of them, we believe, is going to lead a different experience. In the past, the value of the customer was he had a cost advantage, he had a choice advantage, he had a convenience advantage. In our opinion, as was also mentioned in the early presentation today by Shoppers Stop gentlemen today, the cost, convenience, and the choice were the three advantages. Our own view is, in 5 years from now, this equation will change to include two other elements: control and experience. The customer value will be cost plus choice plus convenience, which is already existing. Whichever retailer is able to put control and experience, manage the experience, either the online experience or the in-store experience, or manage the control of the people coming and not going out, etc., is completely going to change the way we put it across. Why this is important is, whether you look at any large format store or a small format store, a client coming in, a customer coming in. You know, I remember when I was in Wipro having interacted with Future Group. Mr. Kishore Biyani at that time told us, if you want to sell solutions to me or retail solutions to me, go to my big bazaar store, find out what is required, and we spent 15 days in one of the busy market of Bangalore in Big Bazaar. When Mr. Kishore Biyani met us, we told them we cracked the problem. He said, what is the problem? He said, you require a queue buster. You require a queue buster, you put technology in the queue buster, things will churn. What do you call the smart checkout system, what is called. So Biyani said, exactly the same reason I'm not giving you any deals at all to you. Because he says, did you visit when you go to my store, did you visit what is the profile of people visiting in? How many men and women? Surprisingly, the more women were visiting. Second question, it says, if it is women visiting, did you check up that time, how many of them are working women, how many of the housewives? We say, sir, most of them are housewives. He said, my experience for a housewife is to experience life. I want them to spend more time in stores, and queue buster asking them to push out earlier is not the kind of experiences what we love to give. He says, go back. Again, we went 15 days, we're doing the wrong thing, just looking at women. See what they are, etc. And we came and told him completely different things about women. He said, I didn't want you to watch that. We wanted to watch what experience they go through. That is what the critical thing, how do you manage the experience, how do you manage the cost, how do you manage the control, how manage the convenience, the new customer equation that is completely going to change the way the technology is changing. The future of retail, the way we see it, this has been the study done by Accenture Corporation, interviewing close to about 6,500 executives globally. It is going to be around technology, around going to be innovation, around going to be consumers, right? Each of them going to have a say in that. We strongly believe what is going to create a big technology focus are these areas. All of them have been spoken in the morning, it is spoken in the evening, and there's a huge focus in whether it's in social, mobility, data security, enterprise security, RFID, lot of work that needs to be done. This is the technology which we believe is going to transform the way the experience equation is now changed to put control and experience which we can cross. There's a lot to do. For example, when I use the word omnichannel, is an example American retailers are facing. American retailers are facing. Previously, they used to have four IT systems in the back end. One IT system will say a call center system which allows you to locate where the store is. The second system is to place through your order. Third system is to do your commerce. Fourth system used to be taking your delivery logistics. So for the internal system is be four different subsystems. They were called as a call center system or a delivery system or logistics system, etc. They're all working together to collapse all the four systems into one omnichannel experience system. This is predominantly strong. This is what possibly some of the large multinational corporations are also doing. So we believe very, very strongly the technology around this is going to be a complete thing. And the question is also often asked is that how much of upskilling is required? Our fear, notwithstanding the brave position almost everybody has taken, saying that the adoption of technology in retail is not going to displace people, our fear is in 3 to 5 years' time, possibly 10,000, 15,000 people, unless they are reskilled and upskilled, could become redundant. What will you do to that class of people coming out? What is the kind of people required? How do they accept technology? People still are scared over technology. How do we get them to start believing AI is the way to go? Is some of the areas on which we are trying to put it across. In the study, what they said, about 72% of respondents, they said, AI offers retailers, in all of them, the underlying message, how AI can be utilized by the retailers is on productive efficiencies. On productivity and efficiencies is the biggest advantage they have. But the AI can fundamentally shift the way in the intelligent virtual assistants, the way Alexa example talked about, Google Talk assistants are talked about, or in-store experience talked about, loyalty program will talk about the store, etc. is completely going to transfer the way put it across. Whether it's AI is going to be a business transformation, AI is going to be a minimum essential thing, our view is 3 to 5 years' time, AI is going to be in thing. AI is going to look, the artificial intelligence is going to make you, force you to look at, how to look at technology completely differently. I've said, what is happening in the marketplace, what are the technology trends, technology like the social media, technology trends like cloud, etc. What is we as NASSCOM are enabling something around this? This is an interesting slide. You know what is common between all of them? They are multinational brands. All of them have got their back office footprint in India, leveraging AI capabilities from India for the global market. Example after example, whether Target Corporation or Walmart Corporation or Pepsi or a Coke, they're all leveraging AI capabilities from India. They're building the global capabilities from India. I would not hesitate to add close about 25,000 people are working for these multinational corporations in India, out of which close about 11,000 of them are doing deep technology work. Deep technology work, it could be machine learning, deep learning, artificial intelligence, etc. I could be happy to share examples on any one of them, but my extreme panels will share. Reason I'm saying is, even if I look at Target Corporation, when they started their mobile commerce and e-commerce journey in 2014, the journey started in USA, but today all digital journey for Target Corporation happens out of Bangalore. Anybody wants to sell a digital solutions to Target, the headquarters themselves tell them, go to Bangalore, explore, it works. They are all experimenting low cost of innovation. They're leveraging technology, they're leveraging people, they're leveraging market to keep what is required. The reason I'm saying is, all the fellow retailers in this room, I'll be happy to share many case studies out of this, but I'm forbidden from sharing in public. I'll be happy to share, but some of my panelists today in the conversation will also help you across. What are we doing to support all of them? Almost all of them are supported by NASSCOM. How are we supporting them? It's through a startup program, 10,000 startup program. In 10,000 startup program, we engage with startups in e-commerce, we engage with startup in retail, we engage in commerce in fintech, deep tech solutions, encourage them, get them nurtured in terms of mentors and accelerators, place it before the retailers for them to adopt it. And very soon we'll be starting somewhere in September, October, a retail accelerator where all the companies are listed before, and I urge all of you to be participative of that. Join, give us your use cases, we'll discover startups relevant to you and allocate startup for you. You can mentor them, coach them, build and contribute to the larger ecosystem to be successful in your own domain. Multinationals are looking at it. I see no reason why the Indian retailers should not be looking at startup ecosystem more benevolently. Like this, we have set up a government along with Government of India, and more importantly with the Government of Karnataka and Government of Telangana in Hyderabad, we are setting up a center of excellence for data sciences. Data sciences and AI. It's in public platform. It's public platform available for all of you. We will be creating the data set that's required for any enterprises, use enterprises like retailers here, technology service providers here, or to the starters, making the data sets, creating models on the data sets available, go to the market. For example, we have already got relationship going on Google's TensorFlow as a tools being available. AWS is giving, Microsoft has given their Azure platform, and IBM has given their Watson platform on a free of charge basis used by startups to develop solution. User enterprises to make use of data at a very nominal fee. Business enterprises can make use of it. The technology infrastructure is being created by Government of India, executed by NASSCOM for people to make use of it. Right? In addition to that, we do every city on an average every month a roundtable discussion on retail. Future of retail, future of deep tech, future of deep tech technology, deep learning, machine learning, etc. I would urge each one of you to take advantage. There's no fee to participation. Our objective is to proliferate the adoption of technology. Our objective is to create India as a retail hub for the world. Just the way multinational corporations are looking at India as the talent hub, we believe that we could be the retail hub for the world. One is to say that China is ahead. Yes, China is ahead, but we have the capability to emerge as a service provider of the world. This is exactly what you're providing for. So those have been the startup here. If you would like to have any enterprise connect, sound us with your good solution. I was very happy to be part of the jury to select the startups yesterday. I'm amazed at the kind of startups what we have. I think we could be the next AI capital for the world for retailers. That's the way we look at it. So any questions that you have, you may post to us and we can be happy to put across. This is my mail ID, and this is the way we look at the retail to look differently by 2025. As I said, it is previously it was cost plus technology, cost plus comfort, convenience. Now please add control and experience that communicates the full story of what the Indian retail will be, the global retail will be, and retail for all of you will be in 2025, right? I will not think I'll have questions. I'll get my panel to start. Yeah? Well, along with my panelists, any tough questions, please reserve my panelists. I've got brilliant panelists, and you will engage with them. And any questions you have, we can take it up in the end. Thank you so much for your time.